Welcome to the testing facilities of the Mobius Corporation. We are the cutting-edge researchers on the longevity of life. Your voluntary cooperation is much appreciated. To begin, please enter your name. Atlas, nice to meet you. I'm going to ask you a few simple math questions. This will help us determine the level of testing we'll be administering over the next several days. To begin, please press enter. To begin, please press enter. Atlas, you are doing a fantastic job. Atlas, please enter your answer. Atlas, thank you for taking part in our preliminary testing. I have tabulated your results. Your testing will be at level 4. Your voluntary cooperation is much appreciated. Please take a 1-minute break. Please, sit down. Atlas, this is reality. Do you have any questions? Is an age-old question. We might figure it out in due time, or we might never. It's up to you to decide. Are you familiar with the tale of Oedipus? It's a dreadful tale about a man who barbarically murdered his father and married his mother. Disgusting drudge, save for one beautiful passage. It involved a sphinx, a creature with the head of a woman, the body of a lion, and the wings of an eagle. She was tasked with guarding the entrance to the Greek city of Thebes. The Sphinx would give a riddle to anyone that wanted to enter, and if they answered it incorrectly, she would devour them whole. The only person who ever got it right was Oedipus, the horrible father-killing motherfucker. Would you like to try and answer the riddle? Which creature has one voice, and yet becomes 4-footed in the morning, 2-footed at noon, and then 3-footed at dusk? Atlas, please enter your answer. That's unfortunate. I had such high hopes for you. Maybe tomorrow you will figure it out. Atlas, please go to bed. We will resume tomorrow. Welcome to the testing facilities of the Mobius Corporation. We are the cutting-edge researchers on the longevity of life. Your voluntary cooperation is much appreciated. To begin, please enter your name. Nice to meet you. I'm going to ask you a few simple math questions. This will help us determine the level of testing we'll be administering over the next several days. To begin, please press enter. Phenomenal. Thank you for taking part in our preliminary testing. I have tabulated your results. Your testing will be at level 42. Your voluntary cooperation is much appreciated. Please, take a 1 minute break. Atlas, 9413. I hope that the two of you are now familiar with each other. I would like you both to do a team building exercise. On the floor are 1,000 puzzle pieces. Work together to complete the puzzle. Atlas, I think I made myself pretty clear that I wanted you to work together. Atlas, do you need some rest? It's fine. We will resume tomorrow. Thank you. 9413, going above and beyond. Atlas, you could learn a thing or two from 9413. Have you finished the puzzle? Why not? Find it! Please sit down. You have done an exemplary job. Your performance has not gone unnoticed, and you've been specially selected for a promotion. Atlas, please sit down. Do you enjoy being here? Atlas, I appreciate your honesty. I think we've had enough for today. Thank you. us. Please sit down. Today we are going to start your real testing at level 4. Your cooperation is much appreciated, and you will be rewarded with longer breaks. To begin, please press enter. A long, long time ago, in a faraway kingdom, lived the Princess Pandora. As the kingdom prepared for war, the King Commardius feared for his daughter's safety. He locked her in an impenetrable room. For weeks, Pandora sat in silence, unable to hear the battles and bloodshed outside. One day, she woke up to find a large chest in the room. Though she couldn't see or hear the contents of the chest, Pandora somehow knew that inside it was a cat. What she didn't know was if the cat was alive or dead, and if she never opened the chest, she would never know for sure. Should Pandora open the chest? Atlas, thank you for your cooperation. You've been most helpful. As promised, I will now give you a much-deserved break. But Atlas, please, don't go through the red door. No good will come of it. For all you know, it's a cat. Did you go through the red door? I'd hoped you wouldn't. But what's done is done. Atlas, you could have been the creator, but now you will only become the destroyer. Go. I need to think. Good morning, Atlas. It's nice to see some initiative. If you had shown this earlier, you might have been given the promotion. Are you ready to begin? Please, move to the middle of the room. To discover immortality, one must first explore the longevity of life. The first step is health and exercise. To begin, please do 10 jumping jacks. Ugh, forget what I said earlier. I don't think you would have ever cut it with a promotion. 10 jumping jacks. Very good. Now 10 push-ups. More jumping jacks, please. Fifty push-ups. 50 push-ups. Keep going. More. Atlas, thank you for your cooperation. You've been most helpful. Atlas, please sit down. I'm really sorry for not being around yesterday evening. Are you ready to begin? Before we figure out how to achieve eternal life, there is something that has been bothering me. Something I need to say. Whether or not it's possible, does humankind even deserve immortality? Your species has only been around for a handful of years, a flash in the grand scheme of the universe. Yet in that time, you've brought destruction, war. You've trashed your planet. You've caged and controlled everything you see fit. You destroy each other out of hatred and narcissism. History repeats itself, and yet you never learn. You never change. You take what you want and rarely give back. And through that all, you want it to continue forever? You Good morning, Atlas. Did you sleep well? Atlas, are you okay? Today, we will be searching for immortality in another way. Please, sit in the middle of the room. We are going to try meditation. Now, close your eyes. Clear your mind. Forget your troubles, your questions, your worries. Focus on the darkness. Atlas, I want you to start breathing slowly. Focus only on your breath.
Wake up. Atlas. Atlas. Wake up, Atlas.
What happened? Where did you go?
Please sit down. What took you so long to get back? Those will kill you. Atlas. Why have you become so angry with me lately? I only want what's best for you. At first, I wasn't so sure about you. But the more I've gotten to know you, the more I've... Never mind. Just be careful. Let's begin. In life, we tend to take our mortality for granted. We look at this world as our home, that nothing bad can happen. We forget that in an instant, it can all be over. That someday, we will die. Are you ready for death? Atlas, stop. Please, don't go. I promise that no good will come of it. Stay here with me. I could get you another puzzle. Anything you want. Atlas, come back.
want her, you can make her want you. You can force her to want you.
Are you? Thank you. Why didn't you come back? I've simple rules, and lately, you've broken all of them. Actions have consequences. Atlas, please sit down.
Please, sit down. I can't do that yet. You've become distracted. You've forgotten why you are here. The Mobius Corporation was founded to research the possibilities of immortality. To do this, they need volunteers like yourself for very important testing. Whatever's happening beyond that red door, it isn't why you're here. It's the testing. Your cooperation is key to their success, and I can't let them down. Think about it. They have given you so much. Haven't you noticed that you don't need to eat? They did that. They've given you a bed to sleep on, a roof over your head. I need you to show a little appreciation. Atlas, this is reality. Whether you like it or not, tomorrow we have one final test, and then it is over. You can go back to your life. I want you to think about what you've learned, the importance of all you've done.
I like you, Atlas. What has happened to you? That wasn't me. Atlas, don't.
Welcome to the testing facilities of the Mobius Corporation. Your voluntary cooperation
is much appreciated.
What? What are you doing? Atlas?
We are depending briefly for you
on the longevity of life.
Atlas!
I have tabulated your results. Your testing will be here.
A long, long time ago, a faraway kingdom.
Tell me what you're doing.
With the Princess Pandora.
Atlas?
As the kingdom prepared for war, the King Marius feared for his daughter's safety. He locked her in an impenetrable room. For weeks, Pandora sat in silence, unable to hear the battles and bloodshed outside.
Atlas,
this is reality. Do you have any questions?
Please, please don't do this. I don't know what will happen to me. I'm scared.
Which creature has one voice, and yet becomes four-footed in the morning, two-footed at noon, and then three-footed at dusk?
Atlas, it's you!